Hello everyone, this is Satyam and in this video I'll be discussing a simple but tricky JavaScript interview problem. So the problem is quite simple actually. You have four statements. In the first statement you declare a variable key and assign the string name to the variable. In the second statement you create an object named person and you assign a property key with value setLog to it. And in the third and fourth line, you just do a console.log. In the third line, you access the key by using the dot operator. And in the fourth line, you access it using the braces. So can you guess the output for this problem? Feel free to pause the video and think about it for a while if you want. I'll just run the program so you can see the output, setLog and undefined. If you were right about the answer, I still feel that you should watch this video to the end because I talk about a few more interesting things about objects and their properties. And if you're not right about it, I'll just explain why it happens. So let's begin by doing a console.table and printing person. So if I run this now, yeah, you can see that the person has key as an index and setLog as the value. The way JavaScript interpreter works is when it sees the second line where you create the person object, it looks at key and treats it as a data instead of variable. So we have a variable named key as well, which has this data name string assigned to it. But when it looks at this line, it treats it as a data itself. So this is equivalent to writing this. So you'd have this data key as a property and this data setLog as the value for that property. So now when you access this person.key using the dot operator, it returns you the value which is setLog. But when you access it using the square braces, then what happens is it evaluates the expression within the square braces. So within the square braces you have key and this expression is actually a variable and the value for that is name. So this line can be said as equivalent to making a console.log on person and name. Now since this object person doesn't have any property named name, it only has a property named key whose value is setLog, it will return undefined. So you'd see this log as undefined. Now that you know by using dot operator, this key is not being treated as variable, and even while creating objects, this key is not being treated as the variable. So this brings us another question. What if I wanted to use the variables as key? So one of the ways to do it would be to create an empty object in the second line. So I'd remove this from here. I'll just create an empty object in the second line. And then I would write on person, use the variable. And since you know that using square braces, it will evaluate the expression key, which would come down to this string name. And then you would assign the value that you want. So setLog. Now you know that a dot operator only takes the data, it doesn't take variable, so you'd have to replace it with name. And on running the program we can see that this person object has a property named name with value setLog, and the access using dot operators and the square braces are working as expected. After ES 2015, we have another cool way to do the same thing. So what I could do is I could put the key within this square braces here itself and assign the value that I wanted to assign, setLog, and remove this third line, and this would work again as expected. We see that the key within square braces is being treated as an expression and evaluated accordingly. For the sake of completion of the video, I would replace the dot name with dot key to show you how this gets evaluated. Yeah, so person.key got evaluated to undefined, and as already explained in the video, this is because on using dot operator, key is being treated as a string data instead of string variable. So this is equivalent to making a console.log on person and key, which gets evaluated to undefined. This concludes today's video. If you liked the video, hit the like button and share it among your friends. Hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to keep seeing more such content. And post your feedbacks in the comment section. See you soon in the next video. Until then, bye-bye.